We're going to call Brian Deutsch and Mr. Hamberg to examine him a little bit.
Okay. Brian Deutsch, attorney.
Experience in dealing with assessing these kinds of compensation for fiduciary? I do oftentimes in the litigation that I'm involved in, that will be, can become an issue to litigate before the court to make a determination on.
Is there any particular methodology that you would use in analyzing compensation for an administrator, the performance of the administrator of the probate code, case law?
Not necessarily. I mean, it's on a case-by-case basis, and under the statutes, the court has a lot of discretion, you know, looking at the complexity of the estate and things like that.
Your Honor, I'd like to offer Mr. Deutsch as an expert in the state administration and fiduciary compensation.
Any objections?
No objections.
No objections. All right. Ms. Gold, as an expert?
Mr. Deutsch, who are you paying to testify here today?
You did.
Are you being paid for your work in this case?
I am.
Can you tell the court what is the compensation?
My hourly rate, which is $325 an hour.
What was the purpose of my attention in this case?
To testify as an expert witness, but more particularly to look at the issue of the compensation being paid or proposed to be paid to you as administrator of these estates.
Okay, and did you do an investigation of the files in this case in order to analyze?
I did. I reviewed the files. You sent me a number of documents electronically, which I reviewed. I also reviewed the original file in your office.
Okay. Did you review the letters of administration?
I did.
Did you review the pleadings in both probate files?
I did.
Did you review the pleadings in the state court file?
Yes, I did.
Were there annual reports to the heirs that you reviewed?
I did. It appeared that you had sent annual reports to all the heirs, and I reviewed those.
Okay. Were you familiar with documents involving assignment claims?
Yes.
And did you review those?
I did.
Do you recall the nature of the state court action?
Yes, essentially it looked like it started out as a dispute between the two beneficiaries of this estate regarding some claims regarding their parents' assets. There was a battery allegation as well included in the original complaint.
Was this a mixture of claims that were peculiar to the estate and also individual claims?
That's what it appeared to be to me, yes.
Did you review correspondence files?
I did.
Did you look at email files in the case?
I did. Although I can't say I read every single email because they were voluminous, but I did review them.
Did you review invoices in this case?
I did.
Okay. I'm going to refer you to, I believe, the exhibits 1.
Okay.
Fees on both estates.
Okay, that would have been hourly rates?
Correct.
Okay. And I think the discovery sheets with summaries on.
That's correct, the first page of summaries.
Now, did you read through all of these entries in these invoices?
I did.
And did you read through all of these invoice entries in relationship to the review of the entire file?
Yes.
Okay. In reviewing all of the file materials that looked at, were you able to come to a conclusion about the requisite skill of the administrator in the performance of his duties?
Yes, it appeared that based on the complexity of the estate that the administrator had the requisite skill. You, as having a lot of experience in these types of cases and our attorney, to deal with the litigiousness of these two estates.
And having reviewed the documentation you filed, were you able to come to an opinion and in reasonable degree of professional certainty whether the administrator, based on these facts that you have reviewed and accepted them, acted with acceptable standards for performance of his duties?
Yes.
What is the basis for that opinion?
Again, begin the review of all the documents that we have already spoken about, as well as a detailed review of these invoices.
Would you know the hourly rate that was listed on these documents?
Yes, it's $300 an hour.
In your experience, is $300 an hour a reasonable rate for an administrator to charge when they are dealing with areas of extra compensation?
Yes.
And did you see also in the file the letter, or in the files the letter that I wrote to the heirs regarding the amount of the compensation?
I do. I believe that was back in 2013.
Yes. Did you see anything in that letter that you thought was unreasonable or out of order?
No.
Having reviewed the documentation file, were you able to come to an opinion within a reasonable degree of professional certainability of material extra compensation set forth in Exhibits 1A and 1B, as adjusted by the statutory compensation, were reasonable under the circumstances of this case?
Yes, I do think that the fees requested are reasonable.
And what is the basis of that?
Again, what we've testified about already, the review of the file, the review of the invoices, and getting, we didn't testify about getting some more background on the case from you as well.
Did the estate administration review of the file involve a usually greater time record than might be expected of the estate at this time?
Yes.
Did the personal representative have responsibilities with respect to assets that were not subject to the jurisdiction of the probate letter?
Yes.
Can you put that at the state court?
It appears as so, yes.
Did the estate, did you review the tax returns to the estate?
I did.
Were you familiar with the tax issues that were raised by the accountant because of the sale of the house on a stepped up basis because of the quit claim deed?
Yes, I did note those from the returns.
Okay. And would that have been a significant tax issue that needed to be addressed?
Yes, it could have been.
Did the personal representative also perform legal services? Did I perform legal services?
Yes, it looked like you performed all of the legal services until the time you hired Mr. Spears.
That's all I have.
All right. Anything
else? No questions, Your Honor.
Very brief.
All right.
Mr. Deutsch, you familiar with the Exhibit 2?
Those may be out of order. You should have yours. Okay.
Sure. Thank you. That document's already submitted to evidence. Does that appear to be a letter from Mr. Hamberg to the counsel for the heirs?
That's correct. It's the letter I spoke about earlier.
Okay. And it indicates an hourly rate of $300 per hour for services and different rates for administrative paralegal work.
Correct.
Now, it, this is a
well, I should say it says different rates for paralegal work.
Yes. Yeah. Based on the representations in that letter, would it be reasonable or unreasonable for an heir or a beneficiary to inquire from time to time about the status of the fees accumulated by the administrator?
I think it's reasonable for an heir to inquire.
Okay. And that's all the question.
All right. Anything to redirect?
Just a clarification. Mr. Deutsch, the rate that you are being paid for your services today, was that a rate that I agreed to pay myself?
That's correct.
So not out of mistake.
Correct.
All right. You can step down, Mr. Deutsch.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Shall I release Mr. Deutsch? You're at the end of the day.
Yes, please.
All right. You're free to go.
Thank you, Judge.
Thank you. All right.
Would it be possible for me to answer the entry call very quickly?
So let's take a comfort break for a minute. How about that?
Appreciate that, Judge.
5 minutes?
5 minutes, thank you.
All right. Thank you.
do not.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Stuart.